My friend, I love you. I love you so much. But just for today, 24 hours, 9:30 to 9:30. No men. Don't talk about men. Stop talking about boyfriends. Stop talking about finding a man. Do, for today, find another subject. Another subject. Wambora. Yes. I'm gonna try, gonna try, gonna try. Work till I die, till I die. Hey gorgeous, welcome to my channel. I'm Kopana Shimange and this is How I Do Things, the show where you send me your questions and I'll let you know how I would do things. Now, I can take it as entertainment or use it as advice. Take it, don't take it, use it, don't use it. Listen, do whatever you want to do with it. Because I'm not a professional. I'm not a professional whatsoever. This is no shape or form, any sort of advice to you. It's just me letting you know what I would do if I was in your shoes. Honeys, today I'm tired. I'm exhausted. I'm finished. I am enough. I'm done and depleted. I'm destroyed. I am so defeated about talking about men. See, how the show works is that you go to my Instagram at Kopana Shimange, look for this picture right here, it's in my Insta story highlights, you click reply and let me know what question you want me to talk about in the next episode. So this week I've been doing a Q&A because my inbox is just jam-packed with questions. However, question about a man next. Hi Kopana. Question about another man next. Try another one. Throwing mixed signals. Question about a man again. Something else. Come on, ladies. Question about a man again. Date with a guy. I spoke to a dude. He's doing this for me. What should I do? He's not meeting my standards. How do I meet his standards? What do I say? How do I dress? What do I do? I mean, men. Boyfriend. Whoa. Stop the lorry. Please, honeys. Can we talk about something else other than men today? Can we talk about something else other than having to find a boyfriend? What to say, how to look, how to dress, how to beg a man? Guys, understand, relationships are so important. They're so important, they're such a good part of our lives, but it can't be the only thing that we are talking about. And here's the secret, no? The secret is that if you learn to fill your life with good things, if you learn to focus on thyself, especially when you're single, all of these questions, all of them. What to say on a first date, how to deal with a guy who's hitting on you, how to deal with a man who doesn't have the standards that you have, celibacy, mixed signals, all of that will be easier to solve because you've focused on something other than chasing after a man. Let me tell you how. Here's a list of things that you should try focus on other than bagging a man, and all of these things, trust me, help you with all your issues with boys. Number one, finish the Bible back to front, front to back, cover to cover. I've had this question before: should a person actually finish the Bible? And at first, when I was younger, probably until about 3 years ago, the answer was no, you don't have to finish the Bible, it's fine, you don't have to finish it. Just as long as you read here and there and you kind of understand and you believe in Jesus, it's enough. Yes, it's enough. Because at the end of the day, our salvation comes from believing that Jesus came down, died for our sins, and on the third day he rose again. We are saved. We are one of his children. We have secured ourselves a space. That is it. But we're still alive. What happens after that point? We continue to live our lives in sin? No, the Bible says we shouldn't continue to live our lives in sin. Rather, we should be chasing after righteousness. We should be looking at Jesus as the author and the finisher of our faith and seeing how we can live like he did while he was on earth, right? So then why shouldn't we finish the Bible? Babes. If you want fullness in life, if you want to find out why is it that some people's lives are here, right? And my life seems to be here. Why is it that some people have this abundance in their life, but me, I'm stuck here? It's because they've read the Bible from the front to the back and they are chasing God's glory, not their own. And they have read the manual, and therefore they are getting the full experience of life. You want the full experience of life? Fetsa Bible le wena o tla bona o itse kgwetsagalang. I promise you, that is my goal, to finish the Bible and to share my experience with as many people as I possibly can, like you. So if you want that fullness, babe, if you want to focus on something else other than that man that you're chasing around, do that. Number two, chase something, but don't chase a man. What do I mean by this? Set an actual goal that will occupy your brain and will occupy your time and will take your energy. So if you decide that, you know what, I think for the month of February, I'm going to focus on my fitness. So every single day for 30 days, I want to do some sort of physical activity for at least 10 minutes every single day. You have to do your research about it. Immerse yourself in the thing. Sink into it completely. What we tend to do is we tend to rush into things. We tend to half-ass things. Half-ass. Half a bum sitting on the seat. Have you ever sat on a seat and you're only sitting with one butt cheek? It's so uncomfortable and you don't get the best experience from a chair. But that's how many of us are with our lives and the things that we do. We decide that we're going to go into a fitness challenge, but we only sit on the chair with only one bum. What is that? Both bums, full bodice on the chair, okay? So how this is going to work is, before you jump into anything, try it on. The same way you would try a dress on when you go buy it. Try it on, so see how it fits. Wiggle it on, stretch, squat, see if it feels good on you. Right, they fit right. And then do a little bit of research and put a plan together. One of the pitfalls that we make when we start a new habit is that we don't make the time for it. And that's what I do in my journal. So this is her daily success journal. And one of my favorite pages is my mini time strategy, which is all about setting up the times when I want to do a new activity. If I want to succeed in something, if I want something to occupy my time and my energy and something to grow me, not only physically but mentally as well, and in my emotions, I make sure I have the time for it. So I think about, what time am I going to wake up? What time am I going to do my makeup? What time am I going to record these videos? What time am I going to do the thing that I want to occupy me? What time am I going to use to research about this thing? The days of half-assing things are gone. No half bums on the chair. Take your full bum, plant it in the chair, and enjoy the process. So get fully into the thing. So research the thing, find out what it's going to take from you, and then when you start the thing, you've tried it on, you know how it's going to work, and you fully immerse yourself in the thing. This is what makes you more interesting as a girl. And this just leads me to number three. Make yourself more interesting. How this happens is that if you follow step number one and step number two, you find fullness in life, right? You find the joy in life in other things other than boys. When you find a project to occupy you and you fully immerse yourself in it, you start to learn about how it works. You even start to learn unnecessary facts that you don't really need to know about that thing. When you go on a date with someone, you have more to talk about. How interesting is it to meet a person who tells you about something that you've never thought of it that way before? A person who reads books, a person who finds out more about their food and can tell you interesting things about their food, or a person who likes hiking and can tell you about different hiking routes. Not only about the different hiking routes, but can tell you about the history behind places. If you decide that I'm going to go to art galleries and museums, and you meet someone and that person asks you about, oh, you're into art and wants to find out more about, that's how you become more interesting and how your first date doesn't become a mess. I know, one of the ladies asked me a question, like, I don't know what to say on a first date. Try and find a hobby, honey. Try and fill your life with other things. Try and research things. If you like movies and television, try and find out about movie budgets. What are the top 10 movies to ever go bust? How much do actors get paid? What do you know about the directors? Stop being a surface level person. Stop half-assing things. Start taking a full experience. Start researching about things. Find a true hobby and find out things about it. That's how you become interesting. That's how you find a man. By focusing on other things than finding a boy, you become more interesting. You have more to say. You have better energy. You're more fulfilled without the guy. And your life, honeys, filled with all the right things. You become the catch. So instead of us as ladies chasing men and trying to find out what can I do and what can I say to land this guy, he'll be chasing you because you're definitely a catch. You're worth the energy. All right, honeys, that was my rant. I've had my rant for the day. I feel fulfilled in my spirit and in my soul. I hope that you guys enjoyed that one. And I hope that in the comments in the question section, you'll be asking more questions about how is it that I can become more of a catch instead of how can I chase this man? What do I say? What do I do to make sure that I bag the man? You need to make yourself a catch, honey. Fill your life with the things that make you the one worth chasing after. Men should be in my inbox saying, how do I catch these ladies that are watching your show? Girl, good stock. Good stock. That's it. That's all I have for you guys today. Hope that you enjoyed it. Until next time, beautiful people. I'm Kopana Shima again. This is How I Do Things. Hey gorgeous, thank you so much for making it to the end of this video, and thank you for watching and subscribing. Feel free to binge watch more videos and head over to my website www.kopanashimaki.com to find out more about her daily success journal and how you can get your hands on a copy. Bye.